All right, taking a look at our 73 Super Beetle here. We got this all done yesterday. We did the oil change and valve adjustment with you guys, and made a short video on that, went over a few things to look for, and did get one question on there. They asked me what the difference between a Super Beetle and a Basic was, or what makes a Super Beetle. So I figured I'd show you a couple things that I know about. One of the things is the dash is sort of redesigned from the original Beetle. It's got the speedometer in the middle. The dashboard's a little more fancy. It's a little more updated looking in there. And one of the other things is the curved windshield. 1971 was the first year for the Super Beetle, and they actually had a flat windshield. But they went to the curved windshield in 72 and stayed with that all the way to the end of production. The next noticeable big thing would be the front suspension. I don't know if you can see that in there, but a Super Beetle uses a strut suspension, and a regular Beetle, let me show you over here, uses a straight axle in the front. I happen to have the fender off over here, so get a good look at the axle beam. But here's the typical layout on a Type 1 Beetle, non-Super Beetle setup. You'd have this front end arrangement with two tubes with a series of torsion bars in there, and then two control arms, one on each side, or two on each side. Upper, lower, a shock, and a spindle. Pretty simple setup. All of the spring rate is in the center of the tubes. They have torsion leaves, and you can drop and lower these by cutting the adjuster here, or adding a select adjuster. Avis adjuster, there's a couple different names for them. On this particular front end, I just cut and turned it and lowered it that way, didn't use adjusters. So that's the main difference between a Super Beetle and the Basic. Same motors, same transmission, same braking system, just a little different styling, and the McPherson strut front suspension would be the biggest difference. And some people like the front suspension. The European guys seem to be able to work with it better than the American guys. I think the American guys have made big gains on the suspension parts that are available for these now, so they're a much nicer car. When I used to work on these, they used to call them the Super Beetle Shuffle or Shimmy. And they would always have a little shimmy in the steering wheel if you didn't keep up on all the bushings and connection points under the car. It was pretty troublesome to get that to work right. Here's the blown out steering dampener. I don't want to touch it. I got my going to the doctor clothes on. Here's the ball joints. These were bad. They have up and down motion in them, and they both had a broken bolt. So instead of three bolts holding them to the car, they only had two. I didn't think that was a really safe thing. So we pulled the ball joints out, put two new bolts in, and two new ball joints and a new steering dampener. And I think this one's pretty good. I also adjusted the steering box in this. It had really a massive amount of play in the steering wheel. And now we got it real sweet. So there's a little adjustment that you can make under the inspection plate in the trunk there on a Super Beetle is where it's located. And there's a plate on the front of a Beetle, but steering boxes usually have an adjusting nut on them where you can tighten the play up. So that's what's going on. That's a short version of the difference between a Super Beetle and a Basic Beetle. Talked to Noel last night on this bus motor. There's still a go on that. I guess the Saturday night is the night of fire here in Orlando, out at Orlando Speed World. So Noel's gonna get ready to go to that, do some racing. I don't know if I'll attend that or not this year. We'll see. It's gonna be cold outside, and I don't do good in the cold anymore, so. Might go to that, might not go to that. Not gonna make any promises. But yeah, so that's what's going on. A little cloudy here today. Not a John Kerry day, and the weather's gonna change a little bit. What's up, boy? Well, I'm going to show the fat cat. You guys don't get to see this dude too much. That's my big cat. Oh, cat fight. Hey! Oh, boy. Hey! got enough fur in your mouth? Go on, beat it. Hey. You're not done. That one's gonna continue. That was a lot of fur for breakfast there. Anyway, that was Soccer Rockers. Now you know why we call them that. All the cats around here are sort of on the wild side. They're all feral, so. Never know what's gonna happen on a cat video in this garage. But yeah, that was interesting. Never caught a cat scrap on video before. So anyway, we'll put this one up. Hopefully that answers some questions. There's one last look at the engine compartment there. I'll put back together with the fresh air hose back on the air cleaner and the new oil's in there. Valves are adjusted and it's all nice and happy. So that's where this one's at. One more down the road. But we'll get back on this motor. Probably get this assembled this afternoon or tomorrow. I gotta finish up these heads. And yeah, so I'll finish these heads up and we'll start assembling this motor. Get it in module form, get the heads done, get the crank built, and we'll snap it together. So that's where we're at. Hope everybody has a great day today. Push that record button, stay warm, and all that good stuff. I'll talk to you guys later. Here goes my buddy Jeff. I was gonna stop by. Early morning visitor. All right, guys, take it easy.